honoring and supporting victims of crime. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Bill Hoblin. He's Director of Community Relations for NOVA, Network of Victim Assistance. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me, Jill.
Before we get into your upcoming events, let's talk a little bit about the work that you do throughout the year, because you assist victims of all types of crime.
We do. We were founded in 1974 as Women Organized Against Rape. 10 years later, we were asked to expand our mission to help victims of all crime, and that's when we became NOVA. So we help victims throughout the county. We have prevention education programs in the schools. We have counselors that talk with victims, and we have advocates who help the victims and their families know their rights and help them through the whole process.
And you also have events as well, and one is a candlelight tribute to victims of crime. And this is really honoring and supporting those who have been a victim.
Correct. We found that at least once a year we wanted to come together to let victims know that they are not alone, give them a place where they can honor their loved ones, and feel some sort of empowerment. Unfortunately, when a crime happens to a victim, they feel as if their power has been taken away. This is a way that we can help restore some of their power.
And this happens on April the 12th, and you're encouraging people to come to this event at Newtown Friends Meeting House. There's also going to be a Tree of Hope as part of this April 12th event. Talk to us a little bit about the symbolism of that.
Well, trees are growth. Trees can overcome a lot of adversity, and our clients are actually creating parts of this tree, and it'll be coming together as a mosaic and will be on display throughout the county. And the Candlelight Tribute is a free event, and it's at Newtown Friends Meeting.
In addition to that, National Crime Victims Rights Week is April 10th through the 16th. What's the significance of this week? You have different events throughout the week, but talk to us about the significance overall.
This is a national push to recognize victims, to help victims, empower them, let them know that in this country we are fortunate enough to have rights for victims. Victims don't always know what those rights are, and that's where our advocates come in to help on a local level, but this is a national push.
And people can reach out to you for more information about the specifics of what is happening during that week, but the theme this year is serving victims, building trust, restoring hope, and that's exactly the point that you're talking about, that there are rights for victims if victims
Yes.
are willing and to access them and know about them as well.
That's right. I mean, if you're dealing with your own personal crisis, it's very hard to step out of yourself and look at the bigger picture. Our advocates don't tell victims what to do. They give them options, and many times victims feel as if their options have been taken away.
And again, that's the important point of this week. National Crime Victims Rights Week is April 10th through the 16th. In addition, we're talking about pinwheels. And pinwheels are fun for
Yes.
kids. They are whimsical. They celebrate childhood. But you are using them as a visible representation of child abuse in Bucks County and the people that have come forward to make a difference for kids.
Exactly. There are, at any given year, approximately 850 reported cases of child abuse in Bucks County alone. And what we want to do with the pinwheels is take this symbol of childhood innocence and not change that at all, but remind people that you can be an advocate for a child. And if you see something that looks like it is abuse, you can report it to Childline. And each pinwheel really represents a brave adult who stood up to protect a child.
And you're having three locations throughout the county where these pinwheels will be planted to really remind people of that and the role of adults in coming forward.
Exactly. It's all about coming together as a community and recognize that we all have a part in the responsibility of the care of our children.
Thanks so much for being with us, Bill.
Thank you, Jill.
We've been talking with Bill Hoblin. He's Director of Community Relations for NOVA. I'm Jill Horner.